बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। आई एम शाजिया मुजफ्फर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन केमिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स डिग्री कॉलेज नवाबशाह, डिस्ट्रिक्ट शहीद बेनजीराबाद। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर, क्वांटम नंबर्स और द एड्रेसेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। Today I am going to provide you the complete information or the complete knowledge about the orbitals with the help of types of quantum numbers. This topic has been available in our chemistry book of first year science, chapter number 3, and the name of the chapter is Atomic Structure. Principal quantum number. It is the first quantum number. It explains the concept of energy levels, shells or orbits. It is represented by the symbol of small n. The value of principal quantum numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. It provides the information about the size of the orbit as well as the energy of the orbit. It indicates the distance and the position of electron where it is available in an atom. These energy levels are designed as K shell, L shell, M shell and N shell. K shell is smaller in size, so it has lower energy. But N shell is larger in size, so it has higher energy. Look at this picture. For the K shell, value of principal quantum number is 1. It means it is the first shell. For the L shell, principal quantum number value is 2. It means it is the second shell, second energy level or second orbit. For the M shell, value of principal quantum number is 3. It means it is the third energy level. For the N shell, value of principal quantum number is 4. It means it is the fourth orbit. All the energy levels K shell, L shell, M shell and N shell are available around the positively charged nucleus. With the help of principal quantum number, we can calculate the number of electrons in each energy level, shells or an orbit by using the formula 2n square. The value of principal quantum number for the K shell is 1 when we applied it in the formula and take the square of 1, it always comes 1 and multiply the 1 with the 2, it will gives us 2. It means K shell contains 2 electrons. Value of principal quantum number for the L shell is 2. Take the square of 2, it will gives us 4 and 4 is multiplied with the 2, it will gives us 8 electrons. It means that L shell contain 8 electrons maximum. For the M shell, value of principal quantum number is 3. When we take the square of 3, it will gives us 9. And when we multiply the 9 with the 2, it will gives us 18 electrons. It means 18 electrons are available in the M shell. For the N shell, value of principal quantum number is 4. When we used it in the formula and take the square of 4, it will gives us value of 16. When we multiply the 16 with the 2, it will gives us 32 electrons. It means N shell can hold 32 electrons due to its bigger size. In this picture, I have mentioned the energy levels, the name of the energy levels and the number of electrons fills in that orbit. K is the first shell, so it is smaller in size and it is the first energy level and it can hold the 2 electrons only. L shell. L shell is the second energy level and it carry the 8 electrons. M shell. M shell is a third energy level or the third shell. It has a capacity to hold the 18 electrons. Now, obviously, the N shell. N shell is the fourth energy level It is larger in size, and due to the bigger size, it can hold the 32 electrons. Azimuthal quantum number. This is the second quantum number. It is also called angular quantum number. It is mainly known as subsidiary quantum number. It gives the information about the sub-energy levels, sub-shells or sub-levels. It is represented or denoted by the symbol small l. The value of azimuthal quantum numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. The value of azimuthal quantum number comes from the principal quantum number, or it may be related with the principal quantum number. If we subtract the 1 from the principal quantum number, it gives the value of azimuthal quantum number. It gives the information about the shapes of the orbitals. We have 4 sublevels, subshells or sub-energy levels. These are S subshell, P subshell, D subshell and F subshell. The side picture gives the idea about the shape of various orbitals. S subshell. S subshell is spherical in shape. It is just like a ball shape. ये एक गोले की तरह से होता है. S subshell contains only one S orbital, because it is equally distributed along the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. 1s orbital is present in the k-shell, 2s orbital is present in the l-shell and 3s orbital is present in the m-shell. All the s orbitals can hold maximum number of electrons, that are 2. 1s orbital is smaller than size than the 2s orbital. 2s orbital is smaller than the 3s orbital. P subshell. P subshell is a dumbbell shape. What is dumbbell? Dumbbells are the manual machine used for the exercise by the weight lifter. It consists of an iron rod having the weight disc on both the sides. P subshell contain 3 p orbital, px orbital, py orbital and the pz orbital. Each p orbital contain 2 lobes. One lobe contain plus sign and other lobe contain minus sign. Both the lobes of all the orbitals are meet at the central point. This point is called noodle plane, where the probability of finding the electron is zero. अगर आप इलेक्ट्रॉन को ढूंढना चाहते हैं तो इलेक्ट्रॉन आपको इस सेंट्रल पॉइंट पे नहीं मिलेगा. अगर इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रेजेंट है, इफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज प्रेजेंट, इट मे बी प्रेजेंट इन द पॉजिटिव साइन लोब और इट मे बी प्रेजेंट इन द नेगेटिव साइन लोब. दिस पिक्चर शो द कंप्लीट लुक ऑफ पी एक्स, पी वाई एंड पी जेड ऑर्बिटल विद द सेंट्रल एस ऑर्बिटल. Each p orbital contain 2 electrons. So the 3 p orbitals contain maximum number of electrons, that are 6. D subshell. D subshell having a shape of clover leaf like. Clover leaf एक ऐसा पत्ता है जिसके 4 corners होते हैं. यहाँ पर भी d orbitals में आप देखिए कि इनके सबके 4 corners हैं. D subshell also called having the double dumbbell shape. Dumbbell shape में आपने 2-2 lobes देखी थी, यहाँ पर आपको 4 lobes नजर आ रही हैं. That's why it is also called the double dumbbell shape. Sometime the bi-lobed word is also used to define the shape of D subshell or D orbital. D subshell contain 5 D orbitals. DXY, DYZ, DXZ, DX square, Y square, DZ square. 3 are present between the axis DXY, DYZ and DXZ. 2 are present on the axis DX square, Y square and DZ square. In the DZ square orbital, both the lobes are present on the same axis. So it has a maximum charge density and it is shown by the circle in this picture. Each d orbital contain number of electrons, that are 2. So the 5d orbitals contain maximum 10 number of electrons. F subshell. f subshell having the 7 f orbitals, f subshell having the saucer like shape, ये बिल्कुल तश्तरी या फिर प्लेट की तरह से होते हैं. There are 7 f orbitals and each f orbital contain 2 number of electrons. So the 7 f orbital contain maximum number of electrons that are 14. Dear student, in this chart I will show how the value of azimuthal quantum number depend upon the principal quantum number. I already told you the symbol of azimuthal quantum number, that is small l, and the principal quantum number, that is small n. Here I have mentioned the energy levels K, L, M and N shell, and sub levels S subshell, P subshell, D subshell and F subshell. The values of principal quantum numbers are mentioned for the each shell. For the K shell it is 1, for the L shell it is 2, for the M shell it is 3, and for the N shell is 4. Now I am going to tell you how the value of L depends upon the value of N. If we want to calculate the value of sublevel azimuthal quantum number, then we subtract the 1 from the 1, it will give us 0, or the value of azimuthal quantum number for S orbital is 0. If we calculate the value of P subshell for the azimuthal quantum number, then we subtract 1 from the 2, it will give us 1. The azimuthal quantum number of P subshell is 1. For the D sublevel or the D subshell, we must subtract the 1 from the 3 or the principal quantum number for the M shell. It will give us 2. It means the value of azimuthal quantum number for the D sublevel is 2. For the F sublevel, it is 3. Number of sublevels. If the value of K is 1, it means it has only 1 orbital, that is 1 s orbital. Value of L or principal quantum number is 2 for the L shell. It means it has 2 orbital, 2 s orbital and 2 p orbitals. For the M shell, value of principal quantum number is 3. It means it has 3 orbitals, 3 s orbital, 3 p orbital and 3 d orbital. For the N shell, value of N is 4. It means it has 4 orbitals, 4 s orbital, 4 p orbital, 4 d orbital and 4 f orbital. Same here the value of azimuthal quantum number. Here it has only one value, that is 0. Here the s orbital and p orbital are present. So it has two values, 0 and 1. And here we have 3 orbitals. So it has 3 values, 0, 1 and 2. Now we have 4 values here or 4 orbitals here. So we have 4 values. 0, 1, 2, 3. We already told you for the S orbital value of principal quantum number is 0. For the P orbital it is 1. And for the D orbital value of azimuthal quantum number is 2. And for the F orbital value of azimuthal quantum number is 3. Magnetic quantum number. It is the third quantum number. This quantum number is obtained when we apply the external magnetic field on the moving electrons. It gives the various orientation of orbitals in the space. It is due to the attraction of electrons towards the magnetic field. It shows the effect of magnetic field on the electron revolving around the nucleus. It is denoted by the symbol small m. Its values are positive as well as negative. The magnetic quantum numbers values are related with the azimuthal quantum numbers. So the values of magnetic quantum numbers are m will be equal to minus l, 0 and plus l. It gives the information about the number of orbitals in each sublevel, subshell or sub-energy level. It also helps us to calculate the number of electrons in each orbital. Dear student, this chart will help us to show what is the meaning of orientation. In the case of S subshell, the value of azimuthal quantum number is 0. It means the value of azimuthal quantum number is related with the magnetic quantum number. The value of magnetic quantum number for the S subshell is also 0. It means S subshell is equally divided along the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. It is not further subdivided and it has only one orientation. One orientation means S subshell has only one orbital, that is S orbital. P subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number is 1. So the possible orientations are 3. 3 that are minus 1, 0 and plus 1. 3 orientation means P subshell is further subdivided into 3 P orbitals. P x orbital, P y orbital and P z orbital. D subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum numbers is 2. It means it has 5 values of magnetic quantum numbers that are minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. It means D subshell is further subdivided into 5 orbitals and it has 5 orientations. Dxy orbital, dyz orbital, dxz orbital, dx square y square orbital and dz square orbital. F subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number is 3 and it has, due to this number of 3, it has magnetic quantum numbers have 7 orientation. 7 orientations are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. It means F subshell is subdivided or further subdivided into 7 F orbitals. This chart content is related with the calculation of number of orbitals present in the each subshell by using the formula 2L plus 1. The value of azimuthal quantum number for the S subshell is 0. When we apply it in the formula, so 2 multiplied with a 0 will be equal to 0. Then we plus it with 1. It will be gives us 1 value. It means S subshell has only 1 S orbital. P subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number is 1. When we multiply the 1 with the 2, it will gives us 2. 2 plus 1 will be equal to 3. It means P subshell is divided into 3 P orbitals, P x orbital, P y orbital and P z orbital. D subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number will be equal to 2. When we multiply the 2 with the 2, it will gives us 4. 4 plus 1 will be equal to 5. It means D subshell is divided into 5 D orbitals. Dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square, y square and dz square. F subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number is 3. When we multiply the 3 with the 2, it will gives us 6. 6 plus 1 will be equal to 7. It means F subshell is further subdivided into 7 F orbitals. Now, the content of third chart is related with the calculation for the number of electrons in each orbital or in each subshell by using the formula 2L plus 1. S subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number, that is 0. When we apply it in the formula 2 multiply with the 0, it will give us 0. 0 plus 1 will be equal to 1. 1 is multiplied with the 2, it will gives us 2. It means S subshell or S orbital contain 2 electrons maximum. P subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number, that is 1. 2 multiplied with the 1, it will gives us 2. 2 plus 1 will be equal to 3. 3 is multiplied with the 2, it will gives us 6. It means P subshell contain maximum number of electrons, that are 6. 2 in the Px orbital, 2 in the Py orbital and 2 in the Pz orbital. D subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number is 2. When we apply it in the formula, 2 multiplied with the 2 will be equal to 4. 4 plus 1 will be equal to 5. Then 5 is multiplied with the 2. It will give us 10. It means d subshell and d orbitals are contain 10 number of electrons maximum. 2 in the d xy orbital, 2 in the d yz orbital, 2 in the xz orbital, 2 in the dx square y square orbital and 2 in the dz square orbital. F subshell having the value of azimuthal quantum number, that is 3. When we use it in the formula 2 multiply with the 3, it will give us 6. 6 plus 1 will be equal to 7. When we multiply the 7 with the 2, it will give us 14. It means F subshell and the F orbitals contain 14 number of electrons. Spin quantum number. This is the fourth quantum number. As we know that Earth moves around the Sun as well as Earth revolves around its own axis. In the same way, electron moves around the nucleus as well as electron revolves around its own axis. This is called the spin of electron or the movement of electron in a circular path around its own axis. This deals with the concept of self-rotation of an electron in an orbit. Spin quantum number is denoted by the symbol of small ms. If we have two electrons are present in an atom, then one is moving in the clockwise direction and the other is moving in the anti-clockwise direction. The electron which is moves in the clockwise direction is shown by the upward arrow, and the electron which revolves in the anti-clockwise direction, it is shown by the downward arrow. The spin of the electron shown by the upward arrow or in the clockwise direction by the plus half sign. And the spin of the other electron which revolves in the anti-clockwise direction, its spin is minus half sign. The first box represents the empty orbital and the second box indicates the one electron is present in an orbital and it is shown by the upward arrow. If we have two electrons in the orbital, then one is shown by the upward arrow and other is shown by the downward arrow. It means one is moving in the clockwise direction and other is moving in the anti-clockwise direction. And the spin of the clockwise direction moving electron is plus half, and the spin of the second electron moving in the anti-clockwise direction is minus half. Dear student, in the last, now summarize the lecture. Quantum numbers. Quantum numbers are basically provide the information about the houses for the electron and the addresses for the electron where the electron is available in an orbit. Quantum numbers are divided into four types and it gives the basic information about the orbitals present in the each subshell. First quantum number is called principal quantum number. It is denoted by the symbol of small n. Principal quantum number provides the information about the position, distance, energy and the size of the orbit. Second one is the azimuthal quantum number. It is denoted by the small l and it gives the knowledge about the shapes of various orbitals present in the subshell. Third one is the magnetic quantum number. Magnetic quantum number is denoted by the symbol of small m. It gives the information about the number of orbitals or how many number of orbitals are present in each subshell by giving the concepts of orientation or under the influence of magnetic field. The fourth one is the spin quantum number. It is denoted by the symbol of small ms and it gives the concept of self-rotation of an electron revolving around the nucleus, or it tells about the behavior of an electron when it is available in an orbit. Dear students, umeed karti hoon aaj ka lecture aapko mukammal taur par samajh mein aa gaya hoga. दुनियाए आलम इस वक्त मुश्किल और परेशानी में है। अल्लाह ताला के हुजूर हाजिरी दीजिए, रब्बे ताला की बारगाह में दुआ कीजिए, अपने लिए और अपने मुल्क के लोगों के लिए खैर और सलामती मांगिए। अल्लाह ताला हमें हर मुश्किल, आफत, परेशानी और बीमारियों से महफूज रखे। आमीन सुम्मा आमीन। थैंक यू एंड अल्लाह हाफिज़।